Welcome back to another episode of Samuel Highlights. I'm Alfie Merritt.
And I'm Jalen Norales. Tonight you will get an inside look on some of the biggest events on Samuel High's campus, from on-campus business opportunities to theater production.
Sounds like fun, Jalen. We'll be right back. Samuel High has many student-run activities and organizations on campus. One of the most popular is the Vikes Inn.
I agree. When I walk by, I see students getting not only school supplies, but snacks and school clothing and gear too. The Vikes Inn is also a place where students tend to hang out and socialize. Let's take a look.
Hey, my name is Alfredo.
Hi, my name is Natalie Lau.
My name is Ivan Han.
Hi, my name is Asha Lopez.
I'm a senior and I am 17 years old.
I'm grade 11 and I'm 17 years old.
Right now I am in 12th grade and I am 17 years old.
I'm 18 years old and I'm a senior here at Santa Monica High School. What the class does is to teach the students about how to run a business and to be an entrepreneur.
You can get real life work experience working at a retail store. You can also learn how to do financial reports such as Z and X reports. An X report is basically saying how much we earned or how much items we sold that day in the amounts of dollars. And what we do is we track our progress from day to day so we can get a graph showing either our progress or decline in a store. And an X report will not wipe out the cashier. The memory and data will still all be there, while a Z report will wipe out the data of that cashier.
I like the atmosphere in the store. It's very fun and you feel almost like a family, let's say.
It's very fun, and also because it's like a student run business, so it's like a simulated business environment that's very unique in the school.
You came here, it's not like a classroom that you sit down and study and the teacher just say something in front of the class. We just came here to work as a group and we work like a team.
What I normally do working at the Vikes Inn is work sales counter. We mostly just stand behind the counter and help people, and we usually sometimes use the registers, or we have someone else use the register.
So if you are working in a Vikes Inn, you would get a free scholarship in your senior years, and also you get a fun experience working with the people in here, and you actually working in a shop that will help you in the future if you go to business degree.
Looks like they have their work cut out for them.
Well, that's one of the things that makes Samuel High so great. Our students strive to stay busy and engaged. We'll be right back.
The Samuel High volleyball team is already highly ranked in the state, but nonetheless, they are constantly improving for every season.
I've seen them in action, and they're very impressive. Let's take a look. Those girls sure know how to get the job done.
They sure do. I'd hope to go up against them. Stay tuned for more Samo highlights.
One of the many clubs that makes a considerable impact on both Samohai and the San Monica community is Team Marine.
From collecting trash on the beach to hosting sustainability seminars on campus, the students involved dedicate countless hours to help improve the environment. Let's see what makes them so special.
Team Marine is an environmental advocacy group located here in Santa Monica High School, and we focus on plastic pollution, ocean acidification, and climate change. We focus on the causes and the effects of these three main issues on the environment, on our health, and on our world.
I joined Team Marine last year at the beginning of my junior year after seeing how many environmental issues there were and thinking that this could help solve environmental issues firsthand by going for a change in policy.
So when I started learning about the environment and marine biology as a teacher, I got really inspired and passionate about the issue of climate change and its effects on the environment, the people, and also the animals that live on the earth. So I joined Team Marine to help make a positive impact and difference on the planet.
Team Marine is a group that does three major things, all part of youth activism. The first part is service learning. Service learning is when students go out into the community and provide a service to humans and other organisms and to the natural habitat.
So I joined Team Marine because we often talk about social justice issues, but they all focus on humans. And I really do believe that a lot of animals and even plants are neglected by these movements. And that's it.
Samo is very lucky to have such great role models from Team Marine on campus, who constantly bring out the best in everyone. Don't go away, we'll return soon with more Samo highlights.
The homecoming dance in-game is one of Samo High's most highly anticipated events of the year. But this year, before the game, students put together a little pre-game treat celebration.
We met with some of the students to see what they thought of the carnival.
This is the first time we've done it, and it was definitely not difficult to get together. It was easy to contact the food trucks. Unfortunately, one of them broke down on the way here. But it's easy. They come, and they just pull up, they get ready, and we had kids that were willing to donate time to do the paint and henna, so as far as getting it together, it was really easy. I think the hardest part is advertising, just making sure people know where it is, what it is. And anytime you do something for the first time, you don't always get the best turnout that you want. It's kind of just getting the tradition started and the ball rolling.
Yeah, I'm so excited for this football game. Like, Sam is going to beat them. Yes!
Let's go!
I'm so hyped for the Ghost game. I'm like ready for the Greedy Run. Like, let's go Greedy! We're gonna win, yeah!
Alright, so I'm super excited for this homecoming game. This is my last homecoming game before I leave as a senior. Also, after the homecoming on Saturday is the homecoming dance. And I'm super psyched and stoked about it because I love dancing. And yeah.
Wow, that looked like a ton of fun. And all the work put into it makes it that much better.
I can't wait to see how they top themselves next year. Stay tuned.
Samhain's Orchestra is one of the best programs the school has to offer, who often commemorate pop culture figures in concerts and other performances.
Most recently, they honored the Beatles with the Beatles at Barnum concert in Barnum Hall. Let's watch.
My name is Jason Aiello, and I teach orchestra at Santa Monica High School.
My name is Joni Swenson, and I am one of the orchestra directors here at Samo High.
This is the fourth year that we've done Beatles at Barnum.
The concert was great. We got it all together with one rehearsal the night before, and it all comes together.
I think, especially after last night's rehearsal, when the students get to collaborate with the band, it's a lot of fun, and you get to see all the pieces put together.
It originally started with a couple of parents of students who played in a band, and a couple of fathers, so they made up the band Father Knows Best. And then they brought the idea with a couple of arrangements of music that they were playing with a full orchestra. So that's how it kind of got started.
Each year we try to add in a few new songs, mix things up a little bit, and some of the favorites. So we would be honored if you have to be asked back.
We had a long rehearsal last night, but I think it's going to be a great show.
That was fantastic. What a great performance.
I couldn't agree more. The Beatles would have been so proud to see the effort put into the show. We'll be right back.
Every semester, people come from all over the city to see the latest Samo High Theater Department production.
This season, they'll be putting on The House of Blue Leaves. Our correspondents here at Samo Highlights were able to get behind the scene to look at what went into preparing the play.
Hi, I'm Kate Soller. I'm the theater director at Santa Monica High School.
You know what your trouble is? You have got no sense of history. You know that? Are you aware of that? I mean, lock yourself up against history. Get drowned by the whole tide of human events. Sleep it away in your bed, in your bag. Zip yourself in, Artie. I mean, the greatest tide in the history of the world is coming in today, so don't you get your feet wet.
What inspires me about this show is that it gives the students, the actors, an opportunity to engage with the character. The students are the most inspiring part about it, the way that they're taking on these roles and making it mean something to them and interpreting it, and their ability to hit the comedic moments in such a way that is really hilarious.
Miss Stroller, Miss Stroller, he told us all about Hollywood and Huckleberry Finn.
I want them to say that they thought it was hilarious, that they were moved by it, that it was riveting, that they were engaged the entire time, and that every student on that stage, every actor on that stage, had complete commitment the duration of that performance.
I like being animals, Artie. You know why? Never heard of a famous animal before.
The historical context of the show is important. The idea of looking at the family structure and how dysfunctional it can actually get, and being able to laugh at it, I think that makes the show important. Its ability to go so dark yet keep you engaged at the same time, so to be able to laugh at stuff that is kind of disgusting to laugh at, in a sense. I mean, we're talking about the Vietnam War, we're talking about mental illness, we're talking about people bombing an area or or mass killings and taking a look at it in such a way that might make the audience uncomfortable and yet probably will make people laugh really hard.
I can't wait to go see the show. It looks like they've really outdone themselves this year.
I agree. This might be one of the best yet. We'll be right back after this short break.
The Associated Student Body, or ASB, puts in lots of effort to reward everyone here at Samoa High, making sure they feel at home on campus.
Let's take a look at one of their meetings and see how they accomplish all their tasks.
What a great group of kids. We'll return shortly with more Samoa highlights. The Regional Occupation Programs at Samoa High help students apply what they learn in the classroom to real-life careers and open doors for improving and expanding on art-related skills and talents.
Students in ROP dance class learn to dance just like professionals do. Let's take a look at how hard they work to perfect their performances.
We did Dance the Dream. It was produced by Richard Carrs, a New York producer with a vision of celebrating the 50th year anniversary of the Martin Luther King Jr. speech, showing that his vision had come to fruition through dance, that many different people, ethnicities, races could come together and celebrate one thing through dance. Each class has about 6 weeks to work on a dance, and we try to get two dances done a semester. The first 6 weeks are normally the roughest because I've got a lot of beginners or people are getting used to each other. An idea or concept is presented. From there, they learn the steps, they go through staging, putting everything to formations. Finally, we turn away from the mirrors, we do everything without a reflection, that way to get muscle memory rather than keeping everything in our eyes and head. And then we move to Barnum Hall, where we stage the dances within the space. and adds lighting, some costuming. We've got 2 6-week units, and then the last 2 weeks before the show is only given to cleaning, polishing up the dances, and making sure that everything is really set. And the kids, they will normally do over the course of 1 year, 4 different dance styles. This is my 7th year at Santa Monica High School. Before this, I was a dance coach for Palisades Peninsula High School, and then before that, and still am, I freelance choreographer for Rhodes in California. I think what inspired me to become a dance teacher is the fact that I was actually planning originally on being a commercial dancer in Los Angeles, and that was my goal all through college. It shifted a little bit. I wasn't marketable. There was a few other reasons, and I decided to focus on my own choreography. I really enjoyed teaching. I really enjoyed creating movement and having dancers make it their own. So that sort of just naturally filtered into wanting to share that with kids. And after teaching lots of different age groups, I feel like high school is where I thrive and where I succeed the most with students.
Wow, we certainly have some very talented students involved in the arts.
And it sure looks like both entertaining and worthwhile. We'll be right back.
I never knew Sam Ojai had so many interesting clubs and people on campus.
I agree. I'm also glad to see that students are working hard to introduce new events and faithfully maintain old traditions.
That's all for this segment of Sam Ojai Lights. I'm Alfie Merritt.
And I'm Jalen Norales. Thanks for watching. We'll be back with more in-depth looks at Sam Ojai on our next episode of Sam Ojai Lights.